To build this house, Samahir Al-Masalmi saved money for almost 20 years. And to do it, she used a monthly salary paid to her by the Palestinian Authority since Israeli forces arrested her husband in 2000. Nabil is serving a 23-year sentence for killing an Israeli soldier, leaving his wife to raise their three children. One is their 19-year-old daughter, Beirut.
My mother does everything from dealing with construction workers, preparing the budget and payments, to buying the necessary supplies from the market. No one helps us. She is doing all of this on her own.
The family tries to stay in touch as much as possible. Samahir says she gets gifts from Nabil, the most precious being her youngest son, Karim. She became pregnant with him through artificial insemination. But Karim especially misses his father.
Karim often asks his dad why he doesn't visit us. I'm tired of visiting. My legs hurt, he says. Why don't you come over? We have enough room for you to sleep. Do you keep warm at the prison? Do you have a blanket and a heater like us, or do you get cold?
Like Karim, more than 4,000 other children have fathers in prisons. Israel collects taxes on behalf of the Palestinian Authority. And since the beginning of the year, Israel has been withholding their payments from that revenue. And this is at the heart of the current financial crisis faced by Palestinians. Israel says the cash encourages violence, but Palestinian officials say the money is needed to support prisoners' families and will keep paying them.
No one will go to prison for any amount of money. Freedom is priceless. Prison is not an easy experience. People don't go to prison for the sake of a salary. They suffer, face crackdowns, and sometimes go on hunger strike.
The United States has cut hundreds of millions of dollars of its aid budget to the Palestinians. And with the dispute over the prisoners' payments, the Palestinian Authority faces a financial crisis and has cut its employees' salaries by half. But it says it won't stop paying the prisoners' families their money in full. Nida Ibrahim, Al Jazeera, the Occupied West Bank.